In this lecture, I will explain you how to determine the cutoff frequency of the low pass filter from the given specifications. Here, this is the specification of the low pass Butterworth filter with only cutoff frequency specified. For this one, at this cutoff frequency, the magnitude is 1 by root 2, and here the magnitude is 1. The expression for this specifications is magnitude of h of j ohm is equal to 1 by, in square brackets it is half, and in the brackets it is 1 plus ohm by ohm c. This is the cutoff frequency to the power of 2n, where n is the order of the filter. Coming to this specification, here this is the actual filter that we need to design, where we have pass band frequency, stop band frequency. We will be specified this pass band frequency in radians per second, and corresponding we will be provided either the decibels in alpha p or the corresponding magnitude 1 by under root of 1 plus epsilon square of the filter. And the other specification is stop band frequency in radians per second, and the attenuation in decibels is alpha s, and the magnitude is 1 by under root of 1 plus lambda square. The equation for this is given here. It is magnitude of h of j ohm is equal to 1 by under root of 1 plus epsilon square in brackets parenthesis ohm by pass band frequency to the power of 2n whole to the power of half. Again here n is the order of the filter. This specification and this specification both are representing the same low pass Butterworth filter. The magnitude function of the low pass Butterworth filter in terms of cutoff frequency is shown here. The magnitude function in terms of the pass band frequency is shown here. Squaring both sides of this equation will give you magnitude square is equal to 1 by 1 plus ohm by ohm c to the power of 2n. For this equation also, squaring both sides will give us magnitude square is equal to 1 by 1 plus epsilon square ohm by ohm p to the power of 2n. These two equations are same. Now we need to equate, say this as equation 1, say this as equation 2. So 1 is equal to 2. We are writing here. Cross multiplying these two, we will get that 1 plus ohm by ohm c to the power of 2n is exactly equal to 1 plus epsilon square times ohm by ohm p to the power of 2n. Again here 1 and 1 gets cancels. Now you take this 2n to each term, then it will be ohm by ohm to the power of 2n by cutoff frequency to the power of 2n is equal to epsilon square ohm to the power of 2n by pass band frequency to the power of 2n. Again here this term and this term gets cancelled. We are interested in this cutoff frequency. So, cutoff frequency to the power of 2n, cross multiplying, you are going to get this term will come to the numerator, pass band frequency to the power of 2n by this one come to the numerator, epsilon square is equal to cutoff frequency to the power of 2n. Now, pass band frequency to the power of 2n by epsilon square. Bring this 2n this side, it will come 2n is equal to cutoff frequency. So therefore, cutoff frequency is equal to pass band frequency to the power of 2n by 2n by epsilon square to the power of 1 by 2n. This will give us pass band frequency. This term gets cancels, power is 1, 2 gets cancels, it is epsilon to the power of 1 by n. So cutoff frequency of the low pass filter is obtained using this equation. In this lecture, I will explain you the complete design procedure of analog low pass Butterworth filter from the given specifications. Here, the specifications are given. They are design an analog Butterworth filter that has a minus 2 dB pass band attenuation at a frequency of 20 radians per second and at least minus 10 decibels stop band attenuation at 30 radians per second. This is the theoretical specification of the analog low pass Butterworth filter. Now, if we map the specifications to the graph, then it will look like this. Here, it is mentioned that passband frequency is 20 radians per second. And the corresponding attenuation is specified as minus 2 decibels. The next is stopband frequency. It is specified as 30 radians per second. And the attenuation specified in decibels is minus 10 decibels. So, the given data is passband frequency 20 radians per second, stopband frequency 30 radians per second, and attenuation minus alpha p is equal to minus 2 decibels, minus alpha s is equal to minus 10 decibels. This minus gets cancelled. Now, there are four steps in getting the design of the low pass filter. Now, the first step is finding the order of the filter from the given specifications. The second one is, after getting the order of the filter, getting the normalized Butterworth filter transfer function. And third step is determining the cutoff frequency of the specified low pass filter from the given specifications. And finally, the fourth step is finding the actual transfer function of the filter. Now, we will see for the first step, order of the filter. In the previous videos, I have explained you how to get the order of the filter from the given specifications. That is, order of the filter m is greater than or is equal to logarithm of under root of 10 to the power of 0.1 alpha s minus 1 by 10 to the power of 0.1 alpha p minus 1, where the radix is 10. Now here it is, by logarithm of stopband frequency by passband frequency to the radix 10. If you substitute the values of stopband frequency, passband frequency, stopband attenuation, stopband frequency and passband frequency, you are going to get this particular equation. And the computing the value is left as an exercise to the listeners. The value is, order of the filter is 3.37. As I told you earlier in my video that this is a fraction, so you are going to get some fractional part. Now, we need to round it off to the next higher integer. So, the order of the filter will be 4. The next higher integer will improve the filter performance. So, order is determined to be 4. Second step. In this step, the normalized Butterworth filter transfer function is derived for order n is equal to 4. And it is 1 by s square plus 0.76s plus 1. S square plus 0.184s plus 1. If you multiply these two, the first term will be s to the power of 4. So, it is a fourth order filter. And the third step is finding the cutoff frequency of the filter from the given specifications. In the earlier video, I have explained you how to find the cutoff frequency. Again, I am mentioning it here. It is passband frequency by epsilon to the power of 1 by n, where epsilon value is 10 to the power of 0.1 alpha p minus 1 by 2. So, it is passband frequency by 10 to the power of 0.1 alpha p minus 1 whole to the power of 1 by 2n. Substituting all the values of passband frequency and passband attenuation, you are going to get the value as 21.3868. And this is also left an exercise to the students. And the fourth step is, after getting the cutoff frequency, this cutoff frequency is substituted into the normalized Butterworth filter to get the actual filter transfer function. That is, the actual filter transfer function H of S is equal to normalized Butterworth filter transfer function, in that the value of S need to be substituted with S is equal to S by cutoff frequency, that is 21.3868. With this substitution, you are going to get the actual transfer function of the low pass Butterworth filter. This completes the explanation of design of the analog low pass Butterworth filter from the specifications.